Got his own back.
That's wild. Wow, really good. What?
I'll explain when the the dicks, he's making weight. You talk about food and stuff and McDonald's and
him and Josh, when they're around each other, they're cutting weight. The other dude's eating right in front of him. They don't go.
Why? Why would you do that?
Before, when that was like, when he was like 15 and Josh is cutting weight, he'd be walking around right next up with a bag of chips. And they didn't give a fuck. That's it, Rick. Go on, let's see this way. Josh is cutting weight. This
hey, right next true story. How do you like the way pita wraps hands? How long did it take you to master pita? Because you're doing a pretty good job.
I don't think I mastered it. I don't know.
So you do how many? Five of those on the wraps?
Nah, like two of them.
Two.
It's different than a fight wrap, though. It's just to protect your hands.
But it's still interesting. It's still, people want to know how the superstar battles one of the best pound for pound fighters. It always gets me that Manny Pacquiao wraps his own hands every day. Like this, with tape. It's not easy to do. That's a Mexican wrap?
What do you mean Mexican? Nah, this is God.
The Mexican gods, that's what it's called.
No.
It's not?
The Mexican gods is over there.
But it's similar, no?
No, this is gods, that's rap, that's different.
What's the difference?
This one's thicker. No, well, this one, the Mexican one is thicker. The Mexican one's for like the kids and stuff, like the...
But Peter, do you...
reusable.
Do you use a new one every day? Like
yeah,
a,
for Bambi.
Other people have their own wraps from home that you buy online, whatever.
There's a lot of Dodger fans on the live or what, Mike?
A little bit. They asked
Pita about the Dodgers. Look, it's good for them. They haven't had a championship in 36 years. It's 1988. So you got to feel bad for them. So they could have this one.
Yeah. People got mad at me that I'm not talking about the Dodgers. Sorry. Bam, does that gel help?
Yes.
You feel a difference when you hit?
I mean, it's not... It's
protection.
Like, yeah, it's protection.
So your knuckles come, your hand comes on safe. You think one day they'll let people use that in a fight? No. He does pretty quick with it, huh?
Yeah.
You have it down. Peter, how many hands do you wrap a week? Never counted?
Hey, Bam.
Yo.
Man, what age you plan to retire?
30.
Dirty 30. And then maybe we see you at BKFB. What is it? Bare knuckle or UFC?
Then we're gonna see one MMA fight out of Bam.
Why not?
I'm 24.
And we got 6 years of practice.
Did you get your ring magazine belt yet? To make you an EsNews belt, at least if you want another belt, you walk into the ring with an EsNews belt.
Man, somebody wants to know your coffee order.
My coffee order, I just get a vanilla latte.
Vanilla latte. No little special something?
Oat milk.
Oh, vanilla latte with oat milk. Man.
You ever tried goat milk? Goat milk? Yeah, it's really good. Mikey drinks all his coffee with goat milk. Pita, you tried goat milk, right? It's pretty good. It tastes
really
a little.
Milk.
So drink It tastes like oatmeal.
I don't really drink milk.
Beat that. Batman had to do his head wrap by himself. How would he be able to do all this?
He knows how to wrap his hands.
Like this?
You know how to wrap your hands.
It's a little harder, but I've never done it. But like with the Mexican hand wrap, it's easy.
But what about the tape part? Like, how do you get the tape going? It's easy. Doesn't look easy. How long did it take you to master it?
I've been doing it a long time.
No, but when you started.
Yeah, I've been doing it. I don't know.
Now it's second nature. You've done it so many times.
You do it a lot. Like, you do it fucking every day. Like, for fights, a little bit different because different guys are different. Like Virgil does a different rap. Virgil doesn't like the gods to go between his fingers. Lindolfo is a little bit different. Everybody, they ask for different.
But different feel. That's why fighters like.
You got to do different stuff for different guys. It's not just one hand wrap. It's not just like one hand that you do for everybody. Everybody's different.
Is there a way you could do a regular? I want to do a little tutorial how to wrap, like a regular wrap.
Which one? The hand wrap? The
yeah, like a regular, regular hand wrap. Like I buy online. I go online, buy a hand wrap. How to wrap?
Right there, we have some.
All right, do one on Felipe really quick.
He did it.
On who? Okay, guys, you're gonna get a quick tutorial from Pita how to wrap hands. So that's you buy that, and it costs like $1, right?
No, they're much better.
They used to be $1, 99 cents. Wait, rest in peace, Joe Chavez. Yeah, really quick, gonna wrap your hands. Mike thinks he's a fighter. He called out everybody.
Thinks? Watch your mouth.
How many amateur fights do you have?
A lot. 36.
Who should he fight? Felipe? Okay, guys, you're going to get a quick...
No, the thing is that every fight, there's a chance of an upset. Pedro Guevara isn't an easy opponent. It's not an easy fight for Bam. But Bam knows that. And Bam knows... Bam just re-signed with Matchroom. He saw, you know, his contract and stuff. Like, he's fighting for, you know what I mean? Like,
for his future.
For his daughter and everything's... Like, every fight's super important for him. Bam's always been somebody that's really dedicated anyways. He's always been somebody that's dedicated. But now, seeing what, you know, what his next couple of years are going to be looking like, he's not going to let somebody to come and take that from him. But Pedro Guevara, the same thing. This is the biggest opportunity of his life. So he's not going
to
take it.
He needs his belt if people want to take, because Ring Magazine still haven't given his belt. Yeah. There's been they've been slipping. But Peter, there's certain fighters that were born to fight. Bam's one of them. They're just natural. They work hard. They're special. Bob Arum once said a great fighter is like Haley's Comet once in 75 years.
That what?
That a great fighter is like Haley's Comet once in 75 years. Talk about Pacquiao, Mayweather, De La Hoya, Gervonta Davis, those caliber fighters.
Stop it.
Bam. Yeah. 1 week away, I can't believe it. You're going to blink it, it'll be fight night. So you're leaving Tuesday?
I leave Tuesday morning.
Man, that's a long weekend.
Tuesday morning. It's very cold out there, huh?
Is it? Cold, and why can't you just go on Thursday like everybody else? Like, bam, go on Thursday.
Fucking press conferences and shit. Bullshit.
No, you probably have to go to the mayor and then go to a community center.
Do all that shit.
And then go to the Rocky statue.
We're not the main
event. He can do it. But I know, but I'm going to be there to do all that. Mexican Americans are a huge force in boxing, and Bam's very popular, so they want to, you know, design the promotion. They want to maximize the promotion.
What's the main event? They can do it.
But you're going to be doing all that next week, Peter. A photo op by the Rocky statue.
Well, we land Tuesday like at 3 p.m. We're not doing anything Tuesday.
So Wednesday, Thursday,
so
Friday.
So Wednesday. Yeah. Wednesday will probably be something, and then Thursday will be the press conference. Friday, Wayne. That shit sucks.
Oscar Duarte in the house.
New opponent.
He has a new opponent?
Yeah.
What happened?
Kenneth Sims. I don't know what happened.
So who's he fighting?
Batir Akhmedov.
Who's that? Why is the name sound so familiar? Is he with Joel Diaz?
Yeah. He beat fought Mario Barrios. I thought he won.
Who else did he fight?
He lost to Ken Sims. A close decision of the fight. A badass fight.
Is that a better fight for him? Is that a come forward guy versus a boxer? Technical wise. Like,
they're difficult in different ways. Okay. Ken Sims is a good boxer. He's
Slick.
Yeah. So that's why that fight was going to be difficult. This dude's strong. And he's a southpaw.
So it's a different kind of, but it's just, it's a difficult fight.
They're you're talking about one of the biggest punchers in boxing. You have Gervonta Davis, Better Bev, and Oscar Duarte. When they land, your head's going to the fifth row.
But they've sparred before. They've sparred before. They've trained together stuff, so they know each other. It's going to be better.
Oscar, you like your new opponent, Batir?
Yeah.
Good fight? Knockout?
Yeah.
What round?
I don't know, because I'm ready for third rounds, but I think that I win for knockout.
He thinks he wins. I love the fact he just speak one word in English before he came to the gym, and he's flowing now. He said he thinks he wins by knockout. Very, very hardworking guy, very friendly. Everybody in the gym's friendly. You have no head cases.
Absolutely not. We got some guys that are kind of idiots.
But yeah, but not but friendly. They're yeah, not yeah. they're not mean spirited. I mean, like, they're not dicks. They're not
dedicated.
They're not Hollywood. You know what annoys me when I see a big boxing star and they ignore their fans.
Yeah,
they go. I see that a lot with some of the big names in boxing. Some of retired fighters too. But then they're fake for their cameras. They'll be nice.
Yeah.
Why not just be normal, Pita? How hard is it just be normal? But yeah, I didn't know he has a new opponent. When did that come out?
Today. We knew about it a few days ago.
Yeah, I wasn't here for a few days, but. I think Duarte is a really talented fighter, and he's improved a lot since he came to this gym. Every aspect. I actually like the fight.
Andy, you're not connected to Wi-Fi, you crazy.
I'm not on the in. I don't have the in. Okay, let me ask people really quick, super fast.
What were you asking?
Okay, on the live, I want an answer. Is this guy funny or not? I say absolutely not.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
He is.
Oh,
hey.
So my boy, too.
I don't even know who that is.
Man.
It's American. God bless the Tide.
Who's that guy?
I don't know his name.
Yeah, me neither.
I don't even know who that is, but I know this guy's unfunny as fuck.
Hey, yo, watch yourself.
Unfunny.
Hey, yo, hilarious.
He has never laughed at any of his jokes, ever. Only time I laughed was when Broner punched him. That was funny to me.
Broner punched on him?
Yeah. He's not funny.
Man, this is the live is live.
Felipe, what was the toughest part for you when you were a pro fighter?
What was the what?
What was the toughest part for you? The training, the sparring, the fighting, dating?
The toughest was the dieting.
Why?
Because back then we didn't know how to make weight. We didn't know how
but
to...
But you made weight.
No, I don't know, but we didn't know how to... We didn't know how to do it properly. Like,
so how did you do
what
it?
What to eat? Were you eating like...
Tuna sandwiches?
No. Like steamed food, like chicken...
No water.
But the thing is, like now, other guys, you know, they drink a lot of water, like a gallon of water, like a day. Back then, in a day, we would just drink like a glass of water.
What, why do you drink a gallon of water a day?
It makes you lose weight.
Water weight.
Yeah, water weight. But back then, we would only drink like a glass of water throughout the day. And we were cheating, you can drink a little more, but.
Did you ever miss weight?
No, I was making
good job.
I was making yeah, I was making
but everything else was easy in boxing.
Everything was awesome, yeah. You know, sparring, training, running. But I think the hardest part was making weight. We didn't know how to do it properly.
You're from Oxnard?
Yeah.
Was it fun being a professional fighter? Like, people saw you, hey, you're the boxer.
Yeah, back then, yeah. Yeah, everybody knew.
Did you get into all the clubs easy because they knew you?
Before we did.
Yeah, we did before.
Yeah, we did.
And now?
Well, I don't want more so. I don't really care.
Now Temple gets in there.
Now my son Temple gets everywhere. Where he's not supposed to.
So, now you work with fighters. You're a coach right here at RGBA. How do you help them make weight from your experience?
What?
You watch them, you say, don't eat candy, don't drink beer, don't drink soda.
Yeah, to my son or the...
Everybody, your son, yeah. The fighters. Do they listen?
Some of them do, yeah.
Tell them the story about the barbershop.
Oh, let me tell you, my son, Temo, he was making weight. The tournament was like 3 weeks ago? Like 3 weeks ago in Auckland. I was a pal tournament. So he was getting ready for the pal tournament. They were gonna weigh in on Monday.
Okay.
So they were leaving. They were gonna leave on Monday. Sunday they train. Other kids train. So my son. He was fighting at 119. So on Sunday he was weighing 119. So then we were training like taking him to the haircut. So I took him. So he was already on weight. He was really bad. So he passed out like two twice. Can you get a haircut?
You take me to the haircut to the hospital?
No, no.
IV something?
I went outside because one of our friends, Flavio, we went outside to go talk. And I came back inside, they're like, hey, your son's on the floor. I'm like, oh shit. He was on the floor like this. And then, he was.
Hey, this is a horrible story.
And then they're like, hey, do we call the ambulance? I'm like, nah, he's okay. He's making way.
This is a terrible story. This is not.
Nah,
this
hey, not bro, it happened. Like, and then they're like, do we call the ambulance? I'm like, nah, he's okay.
But you let him fight?
Huh? He's okay. He's making way.
That's not okay, though. You're not supposed to faint when you make weight. That's what HBO.
Eddie, that's everybody.
Hey, and then they wanted to give him water, and I'm like, nah, he fucking can't drink water.
So, how old is your son?
He's 17 now.
Child Protective Services may be knocking at your door next week.
Yeah, but then he made weight.
Did he win the fight?
He won the first, but the second one.
But that sounds terrible.
Yeah, but that's how it is, man. But,
well, why not go up a weight class then?
Huh?
Just go up a weight class.
Yeah, they do. Eventually, they do.
When they go with the parents, like when they go with the parents, like with Flavio or Jabugo, I tell them he has to make fucking weight. Even if he fucking faints, he has to make weight. They need to be responsible.
When it happens to somebody, like if fucking, let's say, like it happened to Bam once. When he's gonna fight Sonny. So what did he do the next fight? He goes up in weight. And then he fights Gallo and no problem making weight. But he had a like you have the tenía compromiso, like you already agreed that you're gonna fight Sonny Edwards and you have to make 112 pounds. So you're gonna do it. So
but doesn't it affect your performance, Pita?
How did he do?
He did great. But yeah, but Sonny's not that good.
But what do you mean? Undefeated world champ. So
who did he fight?
Huh?
When he faced someone like Bam, he got exposed.
Yeah, Bam's special, but okay. That doesn't mean Sonny's not good.
No, he's the best ever. My bad.
When you have to do it for that fight. Like he had to make weight. Like there was no other option.
But
like,
that's even more impressive than I hear.
We weren't gonna make weight. So then he does make weight. If something like that happens, it's time to go up in weight. So you go up in weight, and then you start doing.
Happened to Mikey when they did the 2 days. Happened to Brandon.
After he fought Robert Easter, what did he do? He went back up to 140. It happened to Brandon. He went up to 140. Yep. When it's happened before, but when that does happen, okay, it's time to go up and wait. But it happens. But for that fight, like you have to make that weight. Like, so what are you gonna do? Just fucking leave your title? Man wasn't gonna fucking leave his title.
Again, in the tournament too. Tournament, they had to make.
Yeah. So Temo, that was the last time he's gonna make that weight. We bumped him up the weight. We didn't know he was struggling that bad.
But you said he fainted twice.
Yeah, bro.
Maybe.
But he made weight.
Maybe the haircut was so bad and he freaked out when he saw himself. Uh-huh.
Yeah, but he made weight. So now, like Pita said, the next time he's going to 125.
Yeah, so he's gonna be up 6 pounds.
He's a big kid.
Yeah. But he had just fought at that weight class like a few months before. So we're like, oh, it should be fine. But no, it got difficult this time. So time to go up and weight.
Every fighter I ever talked to, and I say, what's the hardest part about fighting, boxing or MMA, is making weight. And MMA fighters are even more wild than boxing. They go from 180 to one. Michelle's cousin, 181 to 140.
Yeah.
How 41 pounds? Then he shoots back up. Yeah. How do you do that in one day?
Crazy. Yeah, so like that now at 115, it's a little bit more, it's more comfortable. The wake up when you fought Gallo, you didn't even do a lot, huh? You didn't even do a lot.
He's been on 115 for 6 weeks already.
Oh, yeah. But yeah, now 115 is a big difference for the small guy.
Wait till he goes up to 118, 122 when he knocks out Inouye without even trying.
You know what was crazy that time with Sonny Edwards was that we set it up in my room, and when I picked it up and we checked it, the two scales, it was cool. But I guess there was something wrong with it when we moved it to Bam's room, it was off. So the night before he faints, making weight, fucking gets up, he checks his weight, he's only a pound over, so we're like, all right, cool, just sleep it off. So he went and fell asleep, and then when we went to go check the official scale, like in the morning, he was still like a pound over.
So it was two, but it didn't. So,
No, he was like a pound and a half, or something like that. So we're like, oh shit, like our scale, something happened when we moved it. It was wrong. So he had to, in the morning of the weight, he had to go lose another pound.
There is a loophole in boxing. You know who handles the official scale between the night before the weigh-in to the weigh-in? The promotion. I've seen them once scale back. I'm not gonna say the promotion, Pita. But they scaled because they knew their star wasn't going to make weight.
He's out of Mexico.
They scaled it.
In Mexico, they're always light on the scale. Yeah.
Everybody makes weight half a pound under. Yeah, I was so impressed when every fighter, half a pound under, that's crazy to me.
In Mexico, they always have an under, yeah. I've noticed that.
And you know, I felt like our with Leo and Emiliano, when I took them the last time, it was
perfect. So why do people faint when they make weight? It's very common. What's the reason?
Dehydrated.
Why not drink water? You just said they drink a gallon a day, right?
Not at the end.
At the end. Wait. So this is like the last, like this is the day before the
week. Oh, okay.
So the way, the difference from now to back then is, back then when they used to do their weight cuts, they were basically dehydrated for fucking a month. You know what I mean?
That's horrible.
So these guys now, they've gotten to the point where like, Bam's still right now, like he's drinking. Bam, how much water a day do you drink right now still?
A gallon.
See, so he's still drinking a gallon.
A gallon a day.
So he's going to be dehydrated Thursday night to Friday morning for the weigh-in.
That's it.
For those hours, that's it.
Just a little window.
Yeah.
And back then, us, what we used to do, we would cut water like a month. Well, like the last 2-3 days, no copianos. We wouldn't eat or drink shit.
Yeah, so they go days. So,
but it's funny because...
Without eating or drinking.
Robert, I mean, Pita's dad has a great sense of humor. You have a great sense of humor. How grouchy do you get the night before the weigh-in?
I used to get grouchy.
Who?
Peo. I used to be angry.
Yeah, they're
not. I remember even my dad, guys, we used to fucking argue a lot because of that.
These guys are like that too, though. They get real serious. They get real serious.
Yeah, but some people are always serious naturally, but some people are jokesters. Yeah, he's a jokester. Everything.
Guys, see, weight,
no?
No, but the day before or whatever like that, I was fucking mad.
What are you mad at? Just not
like
hungry?
Anything, but a
lot of fighters like to torture themselves by watching the food channel. I walk in their hotel rooms and the food channel's on. Why would you do that, Pita? You can't eat? Why are you watching food all night? They do that.
Yeah, I know. I wouldn't
do that. Used to do that. Josh and them, they used to go on Twitter and look up food and shit.
But that's torture. Yeah,
Josh and
them. When you're like that, you're thinking like, fuck, I'm going to eat this, I'm going to eat that. You're thinking of everything you're going to eat.
Okay.
But then once you drink water, you forget about all that shit.
Fighter makes weight. What should they eat? What should they not eat?
Charles said the same thing.
Whatever you were eating for camp.
Or more.
You shouldn't switch it up.
So if I never ate a steak, don't eat a steak.
No, don't.
If I only ate salmon.
You shouldn't switch it up.
If I only ate chicken, stick. Nah. Why? For your system?
Fighters are stupid sometimes. They think that their job is done after the weigh-in. And then they could go eat whatever they want and just fucking pig out.
I've seen that. Yeah.
But
overeat.
Your job is done after the fight. So after the weigh-in, you eat like Van Vanini steak. And you guys, the first thing you guys do is go get steak, right? They go get steak. But that's what Charles has been having them, or that's what they've been eating the whole camp. A little bit of pasta.
Is it raw meat or cooked? Like Mike Tyson's eating raw meat right now.
Oh, that's fucking, he's fucking crazy.
He's different.
Just like the liver king, raw meat. Have you ever eaten raw meat?
They should eat.
Never in your life?
No.
They should eat whatever they've been eating.
Raw meat in Japan.
I like that. That was good.
Okay, so what about, I've seen fighters drink sodas after weigh-ins. Yes or no?
No.
I'm not mentioning any names, but yeah.
Navarrete does that shit. Navarrete and Bronco Lara do that shit.
Chavez Jr.
Yeah. Are they all right, Charles? They drink soda?
What about a shot of alcohol? I've seen Alex used to do that.
I used to give him a glass of wine.
Yes or no?
That was his method.
But nobody else does that.
Oh, I've never seen anybody else do that.
So what do you... So just eat what you were eating throughout camp. Don't eat no candy, no soda till after the fight.
No, hell no.
Because your system is so pure,
pasta,
and clean.
Steak, potatoes, rice.
Can you overeat like before, after the weigh-in? Because you're so hungry.
Yeah, yeah.
And how do you...
Nah, but like Felipe said, most of these guys, as soon as you give them their drinks,
that's it.
We have their drinks ready for them, right. You know, what they're going to drink.
Like Pedialyte or whatever?
Yeah, or they have other stuff, like snacks and, you know, it's a...
Like Gatorade stuff? Or like salt, saline, salt, yeah.
Like that. So then they drink that, and then they're not even hungry, honestly. They'll go to the restaurant thinking they're going to eat a lot. They don't even eat a lot.
You don't want them to eat a lot.
They don't eat a lot.
And you don't want them to buy food in the street, like no street vendor food from food trucks or...
No, hell no.
One time Kobe Bryant was in Sacramento, and they poisoned his burger.
See?
You got to be careful. Mikey once ate a bad pizza.
He did. See, so like pizza is also something that's like probably not the best, but Mikey always had a thing of that he likes to eat that. So, and he wouldn't eat a lot. People think he'd have like a slice.
Yeah, but even that.
Before he left to the arena. A slice, two slices of pizza right before he left to the arena.
It happened. And then I know one time a fighter drank a couple of sodas before a fight, and that messed him up too.
Hey, but it's crazy too that there's some guys that it wouldn't affect them. I've seen a lot of
Well, Mayweather, the whole camp drinks soda. He drinks Mountain Dew the whole camp.
Yeah,
he's
right after the
weigh-in. Any junk food. Yeah, that's Floyd. People, fighters go with Floyd to train like him. He eats the burger, doesn't gain weight. They eat burger and fast food. And
he does burn that shit out, though. Yeah.
How come you're not allowed to have coffee in the locker room?
You can't have anything that's not water.
Why?
Huh?
I get alcohol, but why not coffee?
Nah, you can't have anything.
Why is that?
The caffeine.
NBA players drink coffee before games.
They're not about to fight.
They're competing.
Only water is allowed in locker rooms. Unless you're in certain states like Nevada. Which
Gatorade.
Gatorade and Pedialyte, but it has to be sealed.
Okay, a dumb question. Did they actually check if it's really Gatorade and you're not sneaking in anything?
They check the thing to make sure it's sealed. One time, I got in trouble one time. When Brandon was going to fight Diego Chavez.
Mm-hmm.
So I was younger. I was stupid, too. I don't think I have it with me, but Conte sends us like a rehydration packet. And one of the things that comes in there is the protein. Get your gloves, bro? He has a protein, proglycosin. It's sold, you know, publicly. You know, everybody has it, whatever. And he had told me the way he gives it to you in before the fight is in packets, like a Ziploc. Which, so it's a little bit different, but it's still, it's proteicus and it's protein. So I had that in the locker room and he had told us, he's like, if Brandon like gets hungry or whatever, just give him a little bit of this with some water or whatever, just for in the locker room. I was like, all right, cool.
Before the fight.
I should have showed the commission before I did that. So I was in the back of the room and I emptied out a little bit of water and I was like pouring and the commission was like, who's that for? I was like, oh, it's some protein for Brandon. He's like, let me see it. And I gave it to him and it was just a Ziploc bag. And he's like, well, this, like, how do I know this is actual protein? Like, this is just, I was like, oh, fuck, you're right. Like,
what if it's cocaine?
Yeah, it could have been something, different. And I was like, fuck. So then they took me out. They talked to me, whatever. They took it away. They, you know, they tested it and they sent it out.
Yeah,
and
yeah,
it was
yeah.
cool. There was nothing wrong with it. But still, I was supposed to show them. But I was younger. I was like 17.
They should have tested the opponent doing that DTD and Brandon, choking him.
Yeah,
and
I got in a little bit of trouble for that with the Nevada Commission one time because you're supposed to show them everything.
But they're usually
even
cool.
Like food, like Lindolfo takes that little Ziploc bag with like oatmeal and like stuff like that he's right before he goes.
Are you allowed to bring food in the locker room?
So he shows the commission everything he's gonna take. It's like almonds, berries, honey, you know, whatever he's gonna eat, rice, oatmeal, whatever it is. It's like in a little Ziploc bag and he shows them or. If you're going to have a Gatorade or something, you show it to the commission. Or if you're going to have a protein, you show them. Or a protein bar, you show them. Like,
and then they approve it. Yeah.
And that's how I fucked up. I was like, in the back. And that's it made it like look worse because I was like, because I wasn't working with Brandon. I wasn't training. They just, here, you're in charge of this.
Got it.
So I was behind everybody and I was just going like, and I did it right in front of them. So I wasn't trying to hide it, but I was just doing it like an idiot. And there's like, who's that for? I was like, oh, it's Brandon's protein. And they're like, no. Like,
okay, but let me ask you a question as a coach, Pita. Chino Maidana came in a camp, probably 200 pounds. Carlos Adames, 210 pounds. They make weight.
Yeah, they do.
But
that's how Adames weight.
What's Adames at his max?
That was like the worst experience I ever had with somebody cutting weight, bro. Like, oh yeah, my God. Bro.
How much did he start at? But how much
it was
did he start?
First fight together.
Uh-huh.
And but, I had no idea like what his plan was or, you know, how he was cutting
weight.
Wait,
he fights at 454, but what did he weigh when he walked in the door? 220?
When we got there, we were probably 220. He was heavy.
What's heavy?
I don't remember the amount, but he was at least over 25 pounds.
Over there.
Damn.
That's not bad, 25.
Heavy. Come on, what do you think is this?
That's not bad, 25.
I was carrying that guy.
25 between, 25 between weight, fights, bro. Maybe. But not in the last week of camp.
He was light.
But okay, so he makes weight. How was his performance? Did losing all that weight affect him?
The guy out.
Like, okay.
The fifth round. Hey, sometimes look, it's funny because guys will do shit wrong,
and get
sometimes it still comes out okay,
and they win. I remember one time Chino Maidana came to camp, and he was so big for the Mayweather rematch. He showed me film me only from the neck down.
Yeah.
No, neck up. Sorry, neck
you
up.
You never know with things. You know, guys who do crazy shit sometimes, and it works out. You know, I've heard stories of you've heard the same stories of guys from the past who fucking partying on fight week. And they still have their undefeated champions. Undefeated champions.
Ryan Garcia was hanging out with the porn star a week before the Haney fight.
When I was helping him cut weight, it was freaking 4 in the morning, 5 in the morning. We're downstairs in the gym, and I had to move his legs in the fucking bike.
Why? He couldn't move?
Wow. That's the way you do it, man.
Hey, he fights Canelo next? How big is that?
What?
What do you mean? Carlos Adames, you're a champ. WBC 160 champ.
You know what? I would want to see that because that'd be a big payday for Caballo. So that would be good for him. But as a fan, I want to see Canelo fight Benavides.
Do you think it ever happens?
No.
Pita, what's the biggest weight cut you've seen a fighter do here that did it the right way?
You know what? The right
Chino?
Way?
Chino Maidana for...
I was working with those guys back then.
But I'm saying that's a huge weight cut.
Oh, yeah.
But
yeah.
I made with the rematch. He was massive.
Yeah.
Came in with...
We've seen 40, 50 pounds.
And then they perform well?
In a camp. Yeah, they still perform well.
Brandon?
Yeah, Brandon's done. Actually, Brandon, when he fought Timothy Bradley,
That was horrible. He had a horrible fucking
weight cut.
The fucking, he passed out like fucking five times. Dr. Anderson got scared.
He saved the day.
And he told my dad, he's like, Robert, he's like, I have my fucking license of this and that. He's like, I can't be around this. He's like, if something happens to him, and my dad's like, all right, that's fine. And he made weight, but then he performed like shit.
Chavez Jr. told me that when he fought Canelo, he cut the weight so bad that his legs were gone. He said, yeah. Ellie, I saw open your first,
That's the dangerous part about it. That's the dangerous part about it. So the next day, sometimes you just won't recover the way you should. These guys are young, so like I'm saying, Bam had a tough wake up with Sonny Edwards.
Yeah.
But he's young. He was able to recover.
He's only 24.
He had his Pedialyte, the scratch, all that stuff that they give us. And he felt good, and he didn't gain a lot of weight, like from the, you know, he gained like 10 pounds.
That's it.
Which is not a lot. You know, the day of the fight, he was like 10 pounds. He had gained like 10 pounds. So it wasn't like, oh shit, he rehydrated 30 pounds and he had this big advantage. No, but they're young, so he's able to rehydrate.
All right, my last question on this topic. What advice do you have for fighters to stay in the zip code of their weight in between fights?
In between fights is the most important thing, because when you get to camp, that happens. I'm telling you, like that time that Brandon fought Timothy Bradley, that was a fat camp. That wasn't a training camp where you're getting ready for the fight, because you're more worried about oh shit, I have to get my guy on weight, than you are about what you need to do to win the fight.
Just be disciplined. Don't eat whatever you want. Train, run, or lose the weight.
After you fight, depending on who it is and stuff, how many rounds you fight and stuff, you shouldn't take too much time off in between fights. You should be right back in the gym. You know, right back in the gym. Maybe you can take a week off.
Certain fighters.
Thing is, you can take a couple weeks off from sparring. I don't think you should be sparring fucking year round getting hit.
Correct.
But take some weeks off from sparring, but don't take weeks off in the gym. Or don't take weeks off from going to LA Fitness. Don't take weeks off from fucking doing your strength conditioning.
Yeah.
What, like the strength conditioning, the running, the bag work
year round,
you know, like you should be doing that. Like, this is your job. That's it. This is your job. They shouldn't take time off from this kind of stuff. Or that, like I said, the strength conditioning, like that's not gonna affect you. It's not gonna make you worse. It's, you know, you talk about stuff that the guys are doing, and that's not gonna make them worse. If you're not, you know, obviously do it once a week. Don't do it fucking three times a week.
You don't need a coach for that. You could go running in the morning and do it.
I remember Steve Kim.
And it's only $25 a month.
$30 a month, and it's open fucking till fucking midnight. You should be able to, you know.
No excuse.
There's no excuses.
I'm Ellie Seckback. Ellie Seckback reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.